Okay. We're ready to go. Beautiful evening. I really truly believe that this kind of evening is exactly what the Royal Albert Hall was built for. And, you know, we hear a lot and we talk about the community of musicians here, but tonight that is absolutely the case. The camaraderie and bumping into everybody backstage, it's a fantastic atmosphere. I really hope that you're enjoying the evening, and the second half is just about to start. And I'm going to introduce somebody that has been on this stage many, many times through the years. I think probably the first time in the early 1960s. He was here for the concert for George. I don't know whether any of you were here for that. It was an absolutely magical night. And he rounded off the evening with the most beautiful version of I'll See You in My Dreams, with all the flower petals coming down. And in fact, I was on the stage here to introduce his 50th anniversary concert here a few years ago. He's one of my best friends, and it's such a pleasure to welcome to you Joe Brown.
Well, what a wonderful venue. As Bob said, I've played at the Albert Hall many, many times when I was younger. That's to say, not in it, at it, from across the road there. But tonight is very special because I know the Lord's family and they've been very good to me. I just explained, the first time that I met John, I went to his house and he always greeted me the same way. Glass of champagne, dear boy. And I thought, this cannot be a keyboard player with a heavy rock band. But he did, he had a wonderful family. John's father and mother, Miriam, she was a lovely lady, and John's dad, Reg, we got on like a house on fire because Reg knew all the old musical songs. He used to say, oh, I've just got a song here for you, Old Woods Woodwork. And he'd go through all these songs which I'd never heard. And as to John's immediate family, I've got to say this, they were so kind to myself and my late wife, Vicky. When Vicky was diagnosed with cancer, they took her in, they looked after her while I was away on tour, and I will be forever grateful for that. And I do love the opportunity of coming up here and saying something nice about him. Well, when I first moved into the Henley-on-Thames area, there was a load, let me tell you something, I brought the price of bloody property down. But, you know, in those days there was great musicians that lived around there. Most of all, either moved away or passed away. And the latter being our dear John, George Harrison, Gary Moore, loads of other guys around there. There's nobody left around there now except me. But I must say this, of all his friends and everyone that knew him, I'm sure, in the words of George Harrison, he will always remain my sweet Lord. And well, that's about all I've got to say, except I'd like to thank Albert for the use of the oar and introduce you to Paul Weller.
Play a couple of songs from John's first band, or I think it's his first band from the 60s, called the Artwoods. And yeah, here we go. One, two, three.
you very much. It's been an honour to be asked tonight to come and pay respect to the great man. And here's another song from the Artwood days.
Everybody, and another all-star lineup about to take the stage. Please welcome Phil Campbell, Bernie Marsden, Ian Paice, and Nick Fife.
This is Silas and Jerome. I came round this morning, I was feeling like hell. My telephone exploded and I went on that bell. Sounded so loud in my head, I actually thought I was dead. Yeah. Okay, bye. Let me be. I'm gonna lay down and cry. I get this feeling every time that I try. Just hand me three fingers, and the longer it lingers, I begin to feel high. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's a privilege to be here tonight. I never actually got to meet Jon Lord. I just got in the back door here on this stage tonight. I'm lucky to be here. I do have the privilege now of introducing two folk I do know and I have met on my journey, and who were quite important to John. I know that. Mr. Steve Balsamo and Sandi Thom.
Yes, I'll always be soldier of fortune.
Okay. How about this then? First of all, would you welcome Glenn Hughes?
Yes, ma'am.
And Bruce Dickinson.
Yeah. You hang on to that one.
And Ian Paice. And Jon Airey. I think you should take it away. What do you reckon?
Okay, kids, are we ready? We all know this song.
We'll be right back. some love for Brother John. Let me hear you. Let's hear the love for my boy.
And as the song goes, the next song goes, I think John, he didn't believe she was the devil's sperm either.
Or perm.
It's really a great honour to be
here. Devil's perm, actually. Devil's perm.
Devil's perm, or you can call it sperm, but perm. Perm is appropriate.
But never mind. People laughed till she said,
"She's a perm."
Burn.
And that's what we did.
Here we go.
The land, people say the water's there to make you.
Hughes. Mr. Hughes. See you all a bit later. Thanks, John. If he's watching, he's taking the piss and he's happy. All right. We'll see you all in a bit. Not him. He's carrying on. Oh, how do you feel? Give it up for Bruce. And please, please for Ian Paice, a friend of mine. I actually lived with Ian a year. I was only 21 years old. I was asked to join this wonderful band called Deep Purple Mark III, which to this very day I'm really, really happy to say that it was a really extremely emotional time for me, musically and offstage. But things happened in that band which helped me to become somewhat of the man I am today. Thank you, Brother John. Thank you so much, John. Thank you for driving all the way to the West Midlands to meet my mum and dad. I am their only child, wrapping your arms around them, as you did to me and my friends. We're all gawping at you. And you never changed. You taught me how to live when I couldn't live for myself, and you helped me how to do things when things were difficult. And we shared celebration of life. And we shared laughter. Laughter was a huge thing for me and John. Love, laughter. We choose happiness, and we can choose life. And before I sing this song, John and I were recording with Ian, David, and Richie in Musicland Studios in August of 75. And we'd been recording, and the guys went to dinner, and John and I went back to the studio just to mess around, and he started to play these minor 9, major 7 chords, and it brought something up in me that needed to come out that night. So I'm going to sing a song that John and I wrote together. It's the only song we ever wrote together, completely together, and it's special. I hope you like it.
The world around us hangs in doubt. Thank you.
Mr. Glenn Hughes, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it.
So, next band, he knows who it is. I've got no idea, of course. I haven't been here all day. But I can tell you that when I was 15 years old and I heard this band through somebody's bedroom wall, and I knocked on the door and I said, who the fuck is that? And then I sort of went down into the bike sheds. They went, ah! I went, blimey, I can scream just like him. Except I couldn't, not quite. And then I decided that I wanted to be a drummer. Mainly because of the bloke who was the drummer. And then I discovered that I couldn't be a drummer either. Not really. Not as good as him. And the one phrase that confused me as a young adolescent 15-year-old was a quote from Jon Lord, who in later life I got to know and got drunk with a few times and was a splendid chap. But I was a little bit unsure when I read, I think the sound of Deep Purple has a hell of a lot to do with my organ. Oh, shit, I've given it away. What a surprise. Bob?
Ladies and gentlemen, I have two final words to add to the evening, and they are Deep Purple.
has got to be 20 foot tall, and the man standing high. Oh, 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 get to the king. Standing together again, everyone's starting this way. And the man is walking tall. Oh, 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 it's good to be king. Yes, it's good to be king. Bow your head, the carriage is waiting.
Sensational. What good vibes you've been sending up here all night. Thank you. It's much appreciated by everyone. Thank you. That was Uncommon Man. I think we know what it's all about. We've got, in fact, it was uncanny walking in here. We played here a few times, but you never forget the first time. And they had us doing a photograph session over there somewhere for the concerto album. We sat in the stalls and... later on, after the final dress rehearsal, we went for a bite to eat. Everyone was a bit nervous, but so we had some pasta and a little place around the corner and some Chianti. And there had been, you may have read at the time, a little bit of antipathy on both sides towards the project. And but here we were about to do it. And John said to me very quietly over a glass of wine, he said, oh, I wonder how if you've given any thought to the lyrics for the second movement. I said, well, as you know, John, I was going to sort of improvise, but I've thought better of it, and so I scribbled a few notes down on this napkin, and which I put in my pocket. And as we came to the second movement, I
moved across, and John looked at me with a sort of worried look in his face, and I pulled the napkin out of my pocket and put it on the rostrum, and he looked across and he went. And that was the way it went. And now, this is especially for our beloved John. It's, if you wouldn't mind just keeping very quiet at the beginning, because there's a new intro, and it's called Above and Beyond. Thank you.
Touched at the river entwined.
fantastic. Thank you very much. Mr. Bentley Klein, BK, thank you. We love you. Fantastic. Always adds a little something, Dr. BK. Thank you very much. All right, here's a blues thing that we did a long time ago. Is that what we're doing now? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay. Just as well. When a Blind Man Cries. Thank you.
Too soon. Cookman in that room. Found a reason for the things we had to do. I'm a blind man. I'm a blind man. It's when a blind man cries, Lord, you know, he feels it from his soul.
When a blind man cries. Thank you. Okay. All right, okay. I didn't get a list. I got an, I knew what we were doing, but I didn't know. As he said, in which order? This is it's from the 80s. It's called Perfect Strangers. Thank you.
Stay standing up, I think, for this one. All right.
Thank you.
fantastic. Unbelievable. Thank you so much. Thank you.
I'm not to blame now. Hush, hush, she won't my heart. another thing. We've got to get everybody. Everybody on.
Everybody. Oi, come on. Let's get everybody on. You know who you are.
Thank you all for the wonderful spirit and emotion you brought for all the right reasons here tonight. You sent some fantastic vibes down, and we all know why we're here. So thank you very much. We love you. Take it easy. Bye-bye.
We'd like you to all just to really, obviously, we're all here for John, but we would like to just beg a special thanks to Mr. Wixie here, who put a bunch of rock musicians and organised them into a coherent whole, which is, it's about 10 foot deep actually, but never mind. and the man, there you go.
Thank you very much, thank you.
Go home.